Hi, I'm Jenna. I'm a product manager intern on the Edge team, and this is what's new in Edge developer tools for versions 1.13 and 1.14. In these versions, we introduced a brand new tool, the Crash Analyzer. Aggregate selector stats are now always available in the performance tool. The issues tool now warns you when CSS properties trigger layout during CSS animations. We made several improvements to the memory tool, making it easier to investigate memory leaks. We also made several accessibility improvements to the issues tool, CSS overview tool, and DevTools in general. And finally, the DevTools extension in VS Code now has better support for high contrast mode. Let's dive in. In 1.13, we introduced the Crash Analyzer tool. This new tool is useful for applying your DevTools source maps to V8 compatible stack traces that have been recorded by your telemetry system or application monitoring solution. If you use an app performance monitoring system such as Azure Application Insights, you collect error information from your JavaScript applications. But because these stack traces occur in production, they're hard to read and use. With the new Crash Analyzer in Edge DevTools, you can analyze a production crash stack trace and link it back to your original source code. First, enable the tool by going to Settings and then Experiments and checking the Crash Analyzer setting. Then, once you have a stack trace, paste it into the left pane of the Crash Analyzer tool and click the Analyze button. The right-hand pane now shows the original file and function names, and you can click individual stack frames to see the original code. Next, we improved our Selector Stats feature to provide aggregate statistics. Selector stats are used to see which CSS selectors are slowing down performance. The Selector Stats panel can be found in the Performance tool and shows a table of CSS selectors that were matched during a given style recalculation event, along with the time each of them took. In this update, the selector stats are always shown at the bottom of the Performance tool. You no longer need to select a single style recalculation event, and aggregate statistics are given for all style recalculation events in the flame chart. You can now also see and link the style sheets where the CSS selectors are located, and you can copy the table of selector stats data. Next, the Issues tool now warns you when CSS properties trigger layout during CSS animations. This update raises a warning, which is also displayed in the Styles pane using squiggles, to alert the developer about which CSS properties trigger the recalculating of elements' positions in a document during CSS animations. This helps users recognize methods they can use to improve their code performance. Over in the Memory tool, we made several improvements to help you investigate memory usage problems more easily. First, the Memory tool now automatically provides the original object names when you analyze a heap snapshot. As long as your source maps are available, the objects displayed in a heap snapshot recording are unminified, and you can see the names that match your original source code instead of unreadable minified code. We also improved enhanced traces in the Memory tool. The Memory tool can now load enhanced traces that are larger than 1 GB of data. These enhanced traces are useful when capturing performance profiles or memory snapshots and can easily be sent to other users. The enhanced trace has more information about a web page than a normal trace, which makes it easier for other users to explore memory problems under the same conditions in which you experience them. And finally, the Memory tool now also more accurately compares two heap snapshots. The Memory tool allows you to take and compare multiple heap snapshots, and in previous versions of Edge, object IDs weren't being properly tracked by the Memory tool, causing incorrect numbers of new and deleted objects. This issue has been resolved in version 1.14, and object IDs are now properly tracked. Next, in 1.13 and 1.14, we made multiple accessibility improvements to the tools. In the Issues tool, it's now possible to navigate the info bar with the keyboard correctly. In the CSS Overview tool, which is used to display a report of all the CSS code on the page, including elements, colors, fonts, and unused declarations, media queries, and more, we made it easier to navigate the non-simple selector group. First, an ARIA alert message was added, allowing screen readers to announce status information when clicking on a Copy CSS Selector button. ARIA labels now also more accurately represent the list items inside the non-simple selector group. Keyboard navigation was also updated. You can now access selectors using the up and down arrow keys, and you can use the tab key to exit the list. In the activity bar, when using the new focus mode UI, we fixed an accessibility bug where tools labeled were obscured when hovering on a tab. Our last announcement is that debugging with Edge DevTools in VS Code now has better support for high contrast modes. This update improves the high contrast toolbar. Specifically, the toggle element state button is now visible in high contrast mode using the aquatic theme. The button appears with a black background and a white icon when not highlighted. This improves the experience of low vision users. That's it for the new features of Microsoft Edge DevTools in 1.13 and 1.14. But before we wrap up, here's a useful DevTools tip. You can use the console table function in the console tool to display lists of items in a table format. For example, to list the images on a web page in a table, use the code on the screen. But you can also customize the list of columns shown in this table by using the console table's second parameter to list the properties you want to see. For example, to list the images on the page and show only their source and alt text attributes, use this code. And that's it for today. If you have feedback, ideas, feature requests, or bugs, join our community on GitHub at github.com/MicrosoftEdge/DevTools. And be sure to follow us on Twitter at MSEdgeDev and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in Microsoft Edge 1.15.